1975, a 25-year-old Virginian named Richard Joshua Reynolds noticed that the Winston, North Carolina soil was perfect for growing a new flue-cured leaf for chewing tobacco. So Reynolds bought a small plot of land and went into business. In 1890, the New York Biscuit Company was formed by eight of the largest bakeries in the East. 8 years later, they changed their name to the National Biscuit Company. In 1906, Reynolds developed a product that could be rolled in a paper or smoked in a pipe, naming it after the Prince of Wales, Prince Albert. That same year, the Planters Nut and Chocolate Company was established by Amadeo Obici. In 1911, the National Biscuit Company invented the most famous cookie of all, the Oreo. 1912 was the year Lifesavers were invented in Cleveland, Ohio. In 1913, the tobacco industry was changed forever when Reynolds introduced the first nationally marketed cigarette brand.
Isn't sold out art, and it's not jazzed up business either. It's communication, a message. And I have to show them how to do it, how to make it what they want, yet still make it something I love, something that everyone loves. That is art direction.
We believe those who see voice and data as separate phenomena see only the past. We believe those who see the integration of voice and data as a future event do not understand the present. And we believe the future belongs to those who see voice, data, and image as a single universe of information. Universal Information Services. Because the future's on the line.
Hi, I'm Dick Martin. You know, in a market as volatile as the one we're facing today, it's more important than ever that AT&T Network Systems take a leadership stand, project a strong point of view. I hope you agree that that's exactly what the advertising you've just seen does, in an involving and provocative way. It certainly expresses our basic beliefs, our commitment to ISDN, to the public switched network, our vision of universal information services. But even more than that, it addresses our customers' point of view, their problems, their concerns. And in doing that, It makes the solutions that we offer all the more relevant. I hope you find this advertising as exciting as we do, both because it's exciting advertising in itself and because it is a powerful new tool that you can use in meeting the challenges that lie ahead. Because the future truly is on the line.
You are about to make the most important program decision in your station's history. An investment decision about the most successful show on television. Your decision about this show will be influenced by many factors. Its ratings, its ranking, its repeatability, its overall impact on an entire network and affiliates. Together, they're more than the sum of their parts. They've created an unprecedented factor that has changed the face of television programming. We call it the Cosby Factor. The Cosby Factor. It's why the Cosby Show keeps breaking all the ratings records. Why the Cosby Show helped turn around a network, taking it from number three to number one. And knocking out the competition again and again. Why its repeat episodes beat all other primetime programs in their original telecasts. Why the Cosby Show beats all other network programs in every key demographic. Men and women, kids and teens, urban and rural. The Cosby Show will be available locally in every market in America beginning September 1988. You are number one. It'll keep you there and make you stronger. If you're not, it will help you get there. The Cosby Show is unbeatable.